السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله، الحمد لله الذي لا إله إلا هو الحي القيوم، لا تأخذه سنة ولا نوم، له ما في السماوات وما في الأرض وما بينهما وما تحت الثرى، والصلاة والسلام على المبعوث رحمة للعالمين سيدنا ونبينا وحبيبنا وقدوتنا إمامنا مولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحابته ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، ما بعد. فقد قال الله تعالى في كلامه العزيز بعد: أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم، بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. شرع لكم من الدين ما وصى به نوحا والذي أوحينا إليك وما وصينا به إبراهيم وموسى وعيسى أن أقيموا الدين ولا تتفرقوا فيه. كبر على المشركين ما تدعوهم إليه، الله يجتبي إليه من يشاء ويهدي إليه من ينيب، صدق الله العظيم. All praise and glory be to Almighty Allah سبحانه وتعالى، Creator, Nourisher, Sustainer, Provider, Protector, Control of every single thing exists. Peace and salutation be upon our beloved Master Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, on his family members, companions, upon every single Muslim brothers and sisters who follow him, who is following and who will follow the sunnah of our beloved Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam to the day of Qiyamah. My respected brothers and elders in Islam, I would like to remind myself and each and every one of you present here with the taqwa of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, follow the commandments of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in every injunction in your life. My dear respected brothers and elders in Islam, we have reached the month of Rajab. Our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to make this dua: Allahumma barik lana fi Rajab wa Sha'ban wa balighna Ramadan. O Allah, bless us in the month of Rajab and bless us in the month of Sha'ban and make us reach the month of Ramadan. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant each and every one of us the opportunity to reach the month of Ramadan. My dear respected brothers and elders in Islam, at the present situation, we see various type of religious, dini activities which is taking place in this world. When you take a mahalla, a masjid, or a community, we see various type of activities which is called masjids, maktab, madaris, organizations of da'wah, various type of activities. But my respected brothers, when you ask each and every one of them, what is your vision, what is your objective, what is your niyya behind this, many of them gives us an answer which is very vague. Sometimes they don't know why are we doing this. They are not clear why are we involved with these activities. And some of time the answers what they give us, it is contradicting each other. That is the reason why we do not see with so much of activity, with so much of emphasis in the effort of deen, we don't see the brotherhood, we don't see love, we don't see peace which is expected from these activities. My respected brothers and elders in Islam, if you go to a wedding house, you know, so many activities might take place. Some people might be decorating the house, some might be involved in cooking food, so much of things. But you go and consult and ask each and every one of them, they will give you one answer. They will say, you know what, this wedding is taking place at home. Nobody will give any other answer other than this: it's going to be a wedding 2 days, inshallah, after 2 days there's going to be a wedding, so that is the reason we are preparing all these things. They're really clear, this is the essence, you call it the madda. In Arabic we will call it a madda, the essence, why are we doing this? My respected brothers, I want to remind myself and each and every one of you, whoever we are involved in one way or other way in activities of deen, why are we involved in the deen activities? What is the vision behind it? What is the mada? What is the essence? Why all of us are striving towards it? It is the only one reason. Ta'atu Allah wa ta'atu Rasul, iqamatu al-deen wa hifzu al-shari'ah. Obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and to obey Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, establishment of deen of Allah and the protecting the sharia. My respected brothers, when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was giving this mission to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in Surah Ash-Shura, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explains Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the challenges that he's going to face. The challenges that's going to face. And then Allah advised and Allah said, Allah told Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, أَقِئًا أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. Establish the deen, do not divide in establishment of deen. We should not be dividing ourselves into group and sectors in the name of establishing the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If we do that, we are doing the same thing what the Jews did. We are doing the same thing what the Christians did. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is warning and saying, أَقِيمُ الدِّينَ وَلَا تَتَفَرَّقُوا فِيهِ. My respected brothers and elders in Islam, how can we bring and how can each and every one of us, when we work towards same objective, the intention of obeying Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, pleasure of Allah, إِقَامَةُ الدِّينَ, although our efforts are different. One person might establish a madrasa, one person might establish a masjid, maybe one person involved in writing it. Although the efforts are different, but alhamdulillah, we will find a unity within amongst us. Because everybody is working towards it. All of us cannot do everything. We all are working towards it. We are helping each other so we can see a love, bond, brotherhood build on. Our beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was emphasizing this. He was emphasizing on this. When it comes to Sahaba Karam, they had difference of opinion. But Allahu Akbar, their vision was one. Their motive was one. So although they were vision, they were working in a different angle. Allahu Akbar, they had a brotherhood within themselves. They loved each other. They helped each other. This is what that we need in this. Do you know what has happened now? My respected brothers and elders in Islam, why we don't find this? If we rectify ourselves, Muslim Ummah, if we rectify ourselves, the entire nation, the entire community, the whole mankind will, you know, we will see a better future in this. Better future in this world if we rectify ourselves. My respected brothers and elders in Islam, when it comes to our activities, we must always concentrate the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and appreciate other person's work. Appreciate that. We don't appreciate. Shaitan comes in and shaitan will put in a ho-ho. What you're doing is great, what he's doing is bad. We must start appreciating each other. Helping each other. Loving each other. This is part of our iman. Part of our iman. Loving your fellow brother is part of your iman. My respected brothers and elders in Islam, this is what we all have to emphasize. When we work towards something, when we're working towards something, we must be always focused. Why are we doing this? Why are we doing this? Is it to please anyone else? Why did we come here today for the Jum'ah? To please someone else? No, to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To please the riba, the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. To establish His command. That Allah has commanded us to come here for the Jum'ah. We sacrificed everything and we came here. Same way when we involve in the effort of deen. It can be in various angles, various activities. We must always think that this is a ni'mah that Allah has given. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues and says, we cannot give hidayah to anybody. This is something very important. We all must think, we cannot make everyone think like us. Everyone have the same mentality. This is the biggest problem. We are trying to force our opinion, our idea to other person. No. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Holy Quran, that is impossible. If Allah wanted, Allah would have created that. But Allah did not create us like that. Each and every one of us will have a different opinion, different idea, different way of thinking. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala created. But we need to make use of those things, good of those things, accommodate everybody's opinion and work towards it. My respected brothers, when it comes to work of deen, if Allah gives you opportunity to serve the deen of Allah, Allah does not give everyone. We must always take that. This is the greatest opportunity, a gift and the ni'mah from Almighty Allah. This is Allah is using me. It is one of the greatest tasks. It is not easy to do that. Shaitan can divert us. When Musa alayhi salam was requested, you know, told the asa to be dropped down and it was turned into a snake, and Allah told, hold it. Musa alayhi salam did not pray, Wallah, I'm afraid of it. Please protect me, safeguard me, give me the strength to do it. No. Soon as Allah said, he did it. But when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded Musa alayhi salam, go and invite Fir'aun towards the deen, towards Allah, now he's asking Allah. He's presenting his inability to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, says, Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri. This is not an easy task. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul uqdatan min lisani yafqahu qawli. Musa alayhi salam asked me, Allah, you know, expand my heart. Give me the ability. Make my task easy, because it's something very difficult. We cannot do this. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was giving this effort, the mission to Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala explained, this is the effort of Anbiya alayhi salatu wa salam. Ma wasfa bihi Nuha, what Nuh alayhi salam did. Walladhi awhayna ilayk wa ma wassayna bihi Ibrahim, which Ibrahim alayhi salam did. Wa Musa wa Isa, Musa alayhi salam, Isa alayhi salam. All of them, they did the same mission, inviting people towards Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But one thing we must remember, that we cannot give hidayah to anybody. Hidayah is not in our hand. Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues and says, Allahu yajtabi ilayhi man yasha wa yahdi ilayhi man yuneeb. Allah select whom he wills. Allahu Akbar. Ijtaba, yajtabi is a very beautiful word in Arabic. You know, you have so many candidates who are suitable. So many of them. All of them are suitable. Amongst them, selecting someone, this is called ijtaba. Allah. Most suitable person. Most suitable candidate. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala have selected us. Among so much of people, Allah have thought, okay, this person is suitable to do this. Allah. Allah has given us this opportunity. يَجْتَبِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يَشَى وَيَهْدِي إِلَيْهِ مَنْ يُنِيبْ. Who has the thirst, who wants to do this, who has the keenness to do, Allah will guide them. We need to get this. So my respected brothers and elders in Islam, what is our effort in this? All the effort is one vision, obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Everybody, it can be in the masjid, you can ask everyone, they should give the same. Why the masjid is here? In order to, you know, make people obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People should make sujood to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The madaris, the organization, all the main objective behind it, that people must obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. People must come closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through that way they get the success in this world and hereafter. So my respected brothers and elders in Islam, we see, you know, the time is fucking very fast. Last year Ramadan, we didn't even realize we have reached the month of Rajab. 2 months ahead, inshaAllah, month of Ramadan. And we see the time is clocking very fast. So we do not have, you know, we don't know when will be our last time. So this is the opportunity that Allah has given us. Whatever angle, wherever, whatever ability that Allah has given, whatever effort of deen you are doing, in a small scale, nobody knows it, but still, you do it for sake of Allah, to establish the deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and to make people and yourself obey Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Through that we can see a very united Muslim community where we will love each other, we will have a caring attitude towards each other, build this bond. So my respected brothers and elders in Islam, every week we get this message, every week we need to refresh ourselves and think that why Allah has given me this. Why Allah has given me this chance. Why Allah has given me this opportunity. Why Allah wants me to make. We must be actually, you know, this is Allah. We must feel really proud and be grateful for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for Allah selecting us to be part of this, in this ummah, part of the effort of deen of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accept each and every one of us and grant us success in all the effort that we do and get the pleasure of Almighty Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Wa akhir da'wana and alhamdulillah rabbil alamin.